Okay, Agent Mahar here. Can the person with BPD in your life, or who you might be dating, or you've been in a relationship with, or you are in a relationship with, or you might have been in a long-term marriage with, or still are, can that person with BPD get into therapy? If they get into therapy, can they get in there fast enough? Can they be committed? Can they change to save your relationship? And the answer is no. And why is the answer no? Because it takes so much time and work in therapy. And real change, real healing, and real growth is possible for people with BPD. But they have to choose it. They have to unchoose continually being defensively overreactive, super sensitive from adverse childhood experience, to going and working with someone and doing the work that does create healing and recovery, growth, learning, finding self, and change. But that doesn't happen in a couple months or a year of DBT or 2 years of DBT. And I'm not saying all people with BPD are the same, but if you're a loved one, a partner, any other relationship type other than mothers of an adult child, which is very different and specific in the 25%, what you really need to know, you might not want to know this right now, is that this person with BPD in your life, or if you're in the on again, off again kind of thing, or you know, you've been ghosted and you kind of still want them back and you want to try again, and now you're wondering if they've gone to therapy or what's happening. This is all really the peak of codependency in a way. It's a peak of codependency because it is, instead of focusing on yourself, no matter where the relationship is, if you're still in it, you know, like I just said, or not, these people with BPD who can heal and can recover fully, that's not just something I did that. I was told by professionals I did that. It's not just that I decided that for myself. So people with BPD need extensive long-term treatment, which is probably getting harder and harder, not only to find in the world, but to afford, to find and afford. And BPD is hugely stigmatized. And I don't think that there's anything reasonable about that. But I think aside from psychiatry, you know, the pseudoscience of especially American psychiatry and the frickin' DSM, which just pathologizes up the yin-yang. So I believe in looking at BPD through a holistic lens, you know, when I'm working with people with BPD, but also in general. But that's a sort of a harder message to deliver to a lot of people who just been really hurt by somebody with BPD or somebody with suspected BPD. That's another issue out there. Though I find when I work with clients a lot, when they tell me what's really happened and how it happened, how it unfolded, yeah, it pretty much sounds like BPD. Which is, you know, don't forget that adverse childhood experience is, quote, BPD, unquote. Like, to the depth of it, right? Or it can be codependency for people. So what you really need to know today, whether it's, you know, the news you wanted to hear or not, I have to keep it real here to help you heal, to give you the best opportunity with the information that I have to give and share that has, you know, a lot of depth and an aspect of lived experience on both sides of BPD. And also I got two ex-quiet BPDs in, you know, my history of relationships, and one BPD NPD alcoholic from 2004 to 2006. So know what it's like to walk in your shoes. And know, like, when I was in that relationship with the beauty, if you can call it that, you know, it was like a debacle. But it was long after I recovered. Oh, 1 second here. I was really sorry about that. So it was long after I recovered when I was with the BPD, NPD alcoholic. But here's the thing. Did I, with my codependency back then, 2004 to 2006, did I get into the rescue role? Was I enabling? Was I picking up all that slack? Was I trying to do everything for the two? Sure I was. Yes, I was. I've been where you are. And you know what's so painful about that? I mean, that person wasn't going to consider therapy. That person was a social worker, and that was part of the nightmarish aspect of how I got groomed, etc., etc. So the thing is, though, even when people go to DBT therapy with BPD, a year of DBT therapy, I'm not going to say it doesn't change anything, and people are all individuals with BPD, but it can't change enough so they learn how to cope better. They learn skills and tools, but they're still in, they're making progress in a sense. Yes, they're learning if they stick with it and if they're engaged with the therapy, as opposed to, oh, I'm just here kind of like, and they defend against it or resist it. They're still just going to learn in a year of DBT with some variables. They're just going to learn how to manage the symptoms. And what does manage symptoms mean? Well, it means they're not going to be on top of it. It means they haven't done that deeper work of finding the self. They haven't, which really is primarily done through psychodynamic therapy, but not just one or two or three or 4 years of that. It really has to be, it's a longer process. If people are really going to take the journey I took, and I know, I'm sure others have taken, I don't know if they're online or not. I haven't really ran into anyone that I could say, no, has the journey that I took the way I took it. But then you have to remember I had BPD before, you know, Lanahan's DBT was even created. So, you know, it was, and it was a different diagnosis back then. Still, it was really a different diagnosis. They might have thrown up their hands and said, we don't know what to do with you, as opposed to some newer treatments or, you know, since the 70s. But they were still pushing the psych meds. And I said no to all those, which really matters, because people that don't incur such damage. And so the point is, they cannot get enough therapy. It can't happen quickly enough to save relationships. And the other part where I think people with codependency let themselves down so much in thinking that maybe this could be the case. But somebody said on a live stream the other night, really respectful to people when I mentioned their comments as examples, right? That their wife with BPD was, you know, finally agreed, I think today is the day actually, when she was supposed to start online therapy. And so then the person said, you know, what they were going through, what was happening, it was pretty bad. And very painful. And they said, I just hope I can endure long enough till she gets some help. But see, that's not the healthy mindset. It's not a healthy mindset for people with codependency, because people with BPD are not going to change that fast. And then the changes, it's always like a couple steps forward, a few steps back. And behaviorally, the behavior is really often one of the last things to change. Can change incrementally along the way, but not just after a couple months or 6 months or a year of DBT therapy. And I'm not putting down DBT therapy by any means. Even somebody who's been in treatment for 6 months or a year in a psychodynamic therapeutic model is still not going to be able to, they'll be learning something if they're engaging the therapy and sticking with it, but they're not going to be able to change all the behavior. So the symptom management that DBT affords people with BPD, if they really apply themselves, means a lot of behavior doesn't change right away. So it's not a good news kind of message here today, but the really important part is that you hear that, you know, if you've been, you're dating somebody with BPD, it's like, why continue that? And if they're just getting into therapy, like, I mean, nothing against people with BPD, but this is a relational impossibility and you need to take care of you right now. You need to just stop. If you just started dating somebody, find out they have BPD. And the other thing is, for your sake, and then they need to take care of themselves. People with codependency don't even sometimes sit down and do an inventory of how much pain you've accrued. How many horrible things have they said? How much have they blamed you for a whole bunch of stuff? That alone, if they're just starting therapy or they've been in therapy now for 6 months or a year or something, that alone should be still your boundary that you need, that says, hey, all that's happened to me already, I've accrued all of this pain and hurt, And you're probably losing yourself to some extent, as people do quickly in these relationships with people with, you know, especially untreated BPD, but even some significant treatment for some people doesn't have the same effect as it will for others, which is more positive. But none of it's going to be enough to save your relationship right now, because people with codependency are so, with all respect, I say this in no judgment, trying to avoid what you need to find out more about yourself, trying to avoid your own pain by overinvesting, giving, etc., to this person with BPD in your life. And the bottom line is, why aren't you paying attention to how much you hurt? Why aren't you paying attention to what's already happened? And then please know, on top of that, unfortunately, but you really need to get real with yourself. And yes, it means making the most difficult choice, taking the most difficult path forward, but it's the most meaningful path. It is the path that will yield you the most if you travel that healing recovery journey path from, you know, not staying in a relationship with somebody with BPD, even if they started therapy. It's not going to be enough to undo what's been done to you. And it's not going to be enough to change the dynamic of the relationship. And it's not going to be fast enough to save your relationship. So then the question for people with codependency becomes, why are you still overinvested? What about you? Okay, the question is, why are you still so invested? What about you? And what about you and being with you is uncomfortable or painful? And do you know why? Or do you need to know more about your, like the work I do with clients, your family of origin, your, how you're not self-differentiated, what that really means, and your wounded inner child. So people that think that somebody getting a couple months of treatment going to change everything, nope, not at all. The dynamics, the reason why people with BPD do, quote, relate the way they do, which is not healthy and next to impossible for anybody to really stay near, because it's just too volatile. It's just too painful. It robs people. It robs you of yourself. And you're too precious to allow somebody to do that to you. And then everybody gets caught up in, oh, love, love. It's not even about love, actually. It's not healthy love. So the bottom line is, once you find out what's going on, and or you suspect or you know they have BPD, it's time to go. And for some people, they've been in long-term marriages, and you know, you got to remember, years and years ago, when maybe these people got married, wasn't much of any information out there, just like all those years ago when I was in recovery from BPD, before I recovered, healed. And that recovery, by the way, that people can't achieve from BPD, which I have, is, it means, it's like we live life like averagely mentally healthy people who never had BPD. So other people out there giving messages like, you're always going to be dealing with this, da 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 da. They don't know what they're talking about. And clearly they don't know what they're talking about. You know, everybody's a self-proclaimed guru now, talking about BPD and talking about, if they talk about their own experience with somebody with BPD, that's one thing. But then when they start saying, but you know, they have this unique perspective on what it's like to be BPD too, because maybe three or four people talked to them or said something on their channel or on their blog, commented. Well, you know, three or four people is hardly a sample of what BPD really is. And people are all over the map with it. Some people have been in therapy for 10 years and they still have a half a mountain to climb. And some people can get through that in about 7 years, not being finished or recovered in a healing journey from BPD, but they don't have half a mountain left to climb. And then there are people like me. I'm not the only one. I just don't know how many people are on YouTube that, you know, I've seen another YouTuber actually who doesn't even believe herself that there's a quote cure. We don't need psychiatry's cure. That's nonsense. People with BPD do not need any quote cure from psychiatry, and get off their stupid medications too. They're not going to help you. They're just going to hurt you. But there's another YouTuber out there who, you know, talks about having BPD, but like not having symptoms now, but she can't release herself because from BPD because, or go to a therapist and check in and get released by them, because she believes the psychiatric narrative, which is the pseudoscience of psychiatry. So just know, if you're a partner, if you're a loved one in any relationship type, except for maybe the mother and the 25% with an adult child with BPD, You need to take care of you. You need to face what hurts inside of you. You need to face what is the codependency about? Why are you still invested? They cannot get therapy fast enough to save your relationship. And this is the case even after some people have been married 25, 30, 40 years. And it just, and they've accrued so much pain. And then their recovery is much, much longer. And the person with BPD for lots of years, maybe they went to therapy on and off. Maybe they didn't go at all. But people with BPD need their own space to make their own choices and to get this therapy for as long as it takes to get where they need to go. So it's not going to save your relationship. And if you think that today, I don't know, journal about it, think about it, because you're investing and overreaching and maybe for some people with codependency, you're clinging to something there that just works totally against all your interests and your mental health and your well-being. I hope that helps somebody today. Take care.